Hey everyone, so today I'm going to discuss a very important topic in Supabase and TypeScript world, and that is making sure that when you fetch data from your Postgres table, you have to make sure that you link your database shape with your front-end code. So in this case, we are trying to fetch blog posts into our front-end, our components, but we are not really getting any type safety here. The shape of data in this case is any, but we know that blog posts is a table containing an ID, which is a string, created ad, which is a string, or maybe null, title, which is string, content, also string, but we are not receiving any of this information in our front end. In this case, our project is pretty small. There is only one table, so we can make guesswork like this. And we know that the shape of this, is a string, so it'll work fine in this case. But imagine working on a large project with many, many tables, many, many team members. You want to be as responsible as possible when you write this code and make sure that you don't run into any errors, right? You don't try to access a field that does not exist, or maybe try to access a field that is of a different type, maybe a function, maybe a number instead of a string, and run into runtime problems. So the topic of this video is to make sure that we get proper type safety into our data fetching. So the first step is to make sure that you install the Supabase package by running yarn add Supabase. And we need this to be able to generate some types into our front end. So this will take a bit of time. So now that this is installed, now we need to add, we also make sure that you run yarn Supabase login and enter your access token. So this will authenticate you using a token and securely identify which developer it is and whether the developer has access to that database or not, because it is trying to read tables from your project. So make sure you grab an access token from Supabase, and you can do that by heading over to dashboard and access tokens and generate your token. I have already done that, so I'm not going to do that again, but grab the token, paste it here, and you'll be logged in. The next step is to go to your package.json and set up a script to generate types. So the script would be generate types. You can name it anything you want. And there is a tutorial in Supabase documentation which shows what to do. So I'm going to grab this script and paste it over here. And I'm just going to, because I'm using yarn, I don't need npx here. You can just remove this. And I need to either add project ref to my local env, or I can just grab it from my env.local and just hard code it here. So I'm going to go to my env local, and my project ref is simply this. You can also confirm this by going to your Supabase project and go to settings, and then I think it's in general, so reference ID. So this is what we're talking about. You can grab this and then head over to your package.json, and over here just hard code this here. Okay, so this script is going to generate types from your project ID. It's going to generate types for TypeScript and then put it in a folder called types and in a file called supabase.ts. I personally, my preference is to use src folder. You don't have to do that, but I personally prefer that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just prefix this with src and put it there. Okay, so now let me run yarn generate types. Oh, because it's trying to create a file in types, I have to make sure that that exists. So let me go to src and quickly add this folder. And now let me run this again. Wait, what? Src types. Okay, this is strange. Okay. Sorry about that, but yes. So now it has run the script. And now let's take a look at our types supabase.ts. And now we see that we have the following contents in this file. So this is just a shape it is declaring, but this is the important one. It has created an interface called database. And this is the schema, the name of our schema. You can confirm that by just going to the table later. So this is the schema. And then for each table in that schema, it has created an entry in the tables section. So there is blog post, and then there is row. And if you want to insert something into that row, what the shape of the insert object should be, right? This is very, very useful. And we can just directly use this with our Supabase data fetching. And the only thing we need to do is, I mean, Supabase team has done an amazing job. This makes life very easy. And this is pretty easy to add to our code. Just go to our page where we are making this request. So wherever we are trying to create a client, we just have to pass the first argument. And the first argument itself is simply this interface. So I'm just going to type in data base, and VS Code is kindly suggesting us an easy way to import this. I'm just going to press enter, and there we go. So now the client, this Supabase client, is created with the database object, the shape of the database in mind. So now all of our operations are properly typed. If I look at data now, it is no longer any, it has a proper shape. I see content string, created at string or null, ID is number, title is string. Very handy. Also, another thing is, if I didn't know what tables I had, and if I just wanted to guess, I can just simply type supabase.from, and in that gap between quotes, I can just press and hold control and space, and it will suggest all the tables that are present. I know that there are, it shows me that there's a blog post table, and I can simply press enter, and that will be selected, right? And the shape of this data is not arbitrary. It is very, this is done in a very feature-rich manner. So because I'm only trying to fetch any number of rows which match this condition, and there is no real condition here, it knows that the shape of the data should be an array of that row. But if I'm, let us say, trying to fetch something from this table matching a certain condition, like for example ID 1, and maybe I only want one row, and I type in single. Now if I look at the shape of data, I'm just going to rename this to data 2. If I look at the shape of data 2, it knows that because I'm expecting only a single, I'm requesting for only a single row, the shape of data 2 will not be an array but a simple object. So the Supabase team has done an amazing job, right, with type safety here. Also, when you're, let us say, if you want to insert an object into the blog post table, you can, it also specifies what the shape of the insert operation should be. So here, if now once again I can rely on VS Code autocomplete and do control space, or maybe I can just type in, and it will suggest me all the fields that I need to fill. So I don't really need to fill ID, because in this project ID is auto increment, and you can confirm that by looking at the shape of the table, because ID in this case is identity and is automatically incremented. I don't need to pass that as argument, and the TypeScript types reliably tells me that ID is optional. You don't have to enter that. And then created at is optional because it's a date, and it defaults to now. I just have to press title. I just have to enter title and content. So just to give you an example about how feature rich this type generation tool is, and I really, really implore you, please don't neglect this. Make sure that you always rely on type safety as much as possible, and you'll thank yourself later when your project blows up and becomes really big. It makes it very easy for you to make sure that any of the data fetching requests that you make to Supabase are very reliable, and you're only using data that you know that exists in your data, right? With that, thank you for watching this video. So in the next video, we'll discuss how to add login, how to add authentication, and make sure that some pages are protected and some pages are public. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye-bye.